morning and welcome to the Stahls TV Morning Show. It's great to be back, and we do have a great topic to discuss this morning, and it is all on heat printing challenges and how you can solve them as you are working your way through different technologies and transfers with your heat press. I see some of you have joined me. Go ahead and comment in where you are joining us from. We always enjoy seeing what parts of the area you are coming to the broadcast from. Now, a couple announcements before we dive into the topic. We're going to start off with this week's Look of the Week. And this was submitted by Linda. She submitted it on our show and tell that we host every Saturday. And this was done using the adhesive and foil process. All right, so if you're familiar with this, it is a two-step process at the heat press. You start with your adhesive first, you apply that, and then use the foil. So what she did great was she chose a heat transfer vinyl that is great for achieving really fine detail. All right, so adhesive has a nice tacky carrier so that you can get really nice detail, such as the design that she weeded there. So some people find weeding very therapeutic and like to spend a lot of time with that process, and other people try to avoid it. But if you are looking for a way to achieve high detail with this particular product without the weeding process, you're able to do so with your laser cutters. All right, so we do have settings for a variety of our different heat transfer vinyls that you can utilize to achieve fine detail and avoid weeding. I really love how she utilized the different foils in that picture. She did a distressed effect at the top with the gold and red foil, and at the bottom she just used the solid blue. But she built this artwork. I noticed where more people were commenting different things, but she built this. She found the clip art for the sun and then added the rest. So great work, Linda. Very unique. Definitely is going to draw customers' attention to that. All right, a couple other announcements. First is a workshop Wednesday. So we're having that this week. So if you haven't signed up yet and you are near the locations that we're hosting this at, which is Arizona, California, Florida, Michigan, our Transfer Express location, right here at the Stahls TV studios in Pennsylvania and also Texas. So we're going to be doing vinyl cutter boot camp on the Roland GS24 and also Graph Tech. All right, so be sure to whenever you're visiting the Stahls event site to make sure that those classes are at the location that you are planning to attend. Of course, we'll be doing those in the morning, and then a heat transfer vinyl 101 and 201 in the afternoons. All right, so hi everyone, good morning. I see you guys commenting in. Thank you again for joining me this morning. We're gonna go ahead and dive into today's topic, and that is heat printing challenges or mistakes, some of the common ones that people experience when they first start working with a heat press. All right, so one of the most common ones, of course, is a crooked design. All right, so maybe not getting that alignment queued up perfectly, and then maybe being a little off center or crooked. Now, there are ways for you to avoid this from happening, some steps or tools that you can use prior to applying your transfer. So we're gonna head over to the heat press and show you some of those. These are just tips and tricks that we follow so that we make sure we have a center design every time. All right, so starting with your heat press, first I'm going to take this off of the platen. And this is a common way people are finding center of their t-shirt, is folding the shirt in half from shoulder seam to shoulder seam, and then pressing a mark down the center of it so that we can get nice and center, find that center of the shirt instead of trying to eyeball it with the collar or the tag. Right, so a lot of one of the mistakes heat printers make at first is trying to line it up with center of the tag and where that is sewn inside of the shirt. However, sometimes those tags aren't center, so we have to find another way to find center of the shirt. So we went ahead and pressed a mark down the center of the shirt so that we know exactly what is center whenever we go to line up our design. So now whenever I go to line this, I know that this is center mark of the t-shirt, and then I can align my transfer with that. Now we want to make sure that we are finding center of the transfer itself. All right, so whenever we're working with this, We want to make sure that we know exactly what is center of our design. Now this one's fairly easy because this is centered for my logo here, that little point. However, we don't know how much of our transfer is actually center for the carrier piece. So we want to make sure that we are lining up our design on the smooth side, not the sticky side. So we're going to fold this in half from the start point of my design to the end point. Right, so we're able to do that and then just fold the top of the transfer where it is center. All right, so that should line up exactly where the point of my design is, and then I can go ahead and apply. All right, so if you're looking for ways to maximize your time spent at your heat press, especially if you're doing a lot of shirts, this is not a process you're gonna wanna do every single time you load on a new shirt, whether it's a 12-piece order or a 24-piece order. You can go upwards of 100, so it wouldn't be very effective for you to have to do this process every single time you're applying a transfer on a shirt. So we do have a tool known as the laser alignment system. All right, so I'm turning that on over here. There are four lasers that we're working with. You can start to see those lining up on the shirt. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and take this off so I can show you exactly how we have these lasers aligned on here. So it does come with an additional tool. This is called the Laser Alignment Wizard. So it comes with the laser alignment system. And this is what is showing us what center and where we need to line everything up. So this is essentially acting as your t-shirt. Here we have the collar right here, which is falling off of the platen because we never want to work with a t-shirt with the collar on the platen because that can cause uneven pressure. All right, so for the first step, we're gonna work with number one, right? So that's my laser going exactly center, and here is my key guide right here. All right, so it says number one is center, so I wanna make sure I'm lining up my first laser with number one, and then so on and so forth. It's gonna do all of your common placements, so number two is gonna be the top front of your shirt where you wanna place the top of your design. It's gonna do the top of the back of the shirt and also your left chest. Now it has an additional one for doing a diagonal or angle print, all right? So if you wanna move maybe the fourth laser, since that's the last one, and line it up with that and keep everything else set up as is, those are gonna be the most common placements that are gonna help you with being able to line everything up. A lot of people find this very effective whenever they're doing large runs with their orders. But that's just a way to kind of maximize that. Other people are using rulers or some of the clear templates that you can lay onto your garment and help with alignment. All right, I'm a little long-winded, so if you guys have any questions, feel free to comment those in. We'll be going back and visiting those to make sure we have any questions that are being answered. All right, hi, Ralph, Mike, Michelle, Will. Thank you guys for commenting in. Good morning to you as well. All right, so that covers crooked design, all right? So those are just some tips, tricks, and tools that you can utilize to make sure that you are lining up your design correctly every time. All right, our next common mistake is a backward design, all right? And we have a quick snip of what happened whenever we did not mirror our heat transfer vinyl. So you can see we're going to apply this and the design is completely backward. All right, so this is most commonly done with heat transfer vinyl because whenever you're loading in your roll of heat transfer, you have to mirror your design, not send it in a positive image. That way, whenever we weed away the excess material and we go to apply, it is adhesive side down. All right, so you can see whenever I flipped that over and was ready to apply it, the heat transfer vinyl was backwards, right? So there are other transfer types that this is a common mistake for. It happens with sublimation if your design isn't mirrored. And then also Plastisol ink transfers come mirrored as well, all right? So we always want the design to apply adhesive side down. So we have to make sure that we are sending our design to cut in a mirror image before we send it. Now, there are ways to avoid this prior to going and cutting a whole job without realizing you even mirrored it until you get to the weeding process or even to the heat application process. So we always recommend just running a full job, or not a full job, but a full application from start to finish, so that you realize the first mistake by just doing one as opposed to sending a full job. That can be one of the most costly mistakes there are out there, is wasting a ton of heat transfer vinyl because we forgot to mirror an image, but we don't realize it until we go to heat apply or weed away that material. That's a lot of waste to make up for, making it one of the most costly mistakes out there. So being able to do the job from start, or one piece from start to finish, so that is loading in the material, cutting one design, weeding one design, and then applying, that can help you realize what mistakes you made through one practice run, and then being able to fix the issue or the mistake for the next jobs that you're going to do. Now, there are some industry programs out there. Most come with your vinyl cutters, if you're working with, well, it can be anywhere from a Cricut upwards to a Roland GS24. Those do have a program that come with the cutters where the mirror option is in there, so that you're never missing that step. Some will even alert you to say, you know, we're not going to cut this. Did you mirror the design? But that is most commonly made with heat transfer vinyl. So just be get in the habit of making that one step that you go through before you send your designs to cut, to avoid that option. Okay, so that is design backwards. So far, if you are just joining us, we are going over top heat printing mistakes and how to solve them. We went over how to solve heat applying a crooked design or off center, and then if your design is backward. Now there is that terrible issue where we get something stuck to our upper heating element because we applied it upside down. All right, so here is a quick clip of us applying a pre-cut number backwards and upside down onto the jersey. And you can see that the adhesive of this number actually stuck to the cover sheet. And we're able to save the jersey because the adhesive didn't apply to it. All right, so we're able to just peel that off and go in with another pre-cut number there. So we're only losing on the transfer. We didn't ruin the jersey at all, but there's always that instance where we forget to use a cover sheet, and this is why we recommend using a cover sheet so often, is so that we're keeping our upper heating element from any damage. So if I didn't use a cover sheet, that would be worst case scenario. That number would actually stick up to my upper heating element. Wouldn't necessarily ruin it because we can get it off. So one way to avoid that is always try to get in the habit of using a cover sheet. However, if you didn't, all you have to do is turn your heat press off. Make sure it's still warm. Get an abrasion resistant scrub and something very soft to wipe the heating element, because we don't want to scratch it with any harsh fibers from, say, a paper towel or anything like that. We just use an old t-shirt or something smooth and a soft scrub type of cleaner to wipe that off. So make sure it's still a little warm so that adhesive is still activated on the upper heating element. But you can get that off. Just make sure you're not burning yourself. We still want it to be a little warm whenever we're wiping that off. So it should come up with a couple wipes of the t-shirt and the scrub, and then it's good as new. All right, so avoid that by using a cover sheet always, getting in the habit of that. But you do have a solution if that is a problem. If you haven't made that mistake, I'm sure you will eventually. Hopefully not, but we've all been there. All right. The next mistake is choosing a transfer that isn't for the right color garment. All right, so our transfers aren't applying or aren't showing up on a dark colored garment. So here's a prime example of that. Right, and this was just one of those things where we didn't consider the type of transfer we were using whenever we applied it to a dark garment. Now, this is most commonly seen in sublimation, because we recommend for sublimation you are using 100% polyester and light colored garments. All right, so whenever you are using a sublimation transfer, it can only apply to, first, 100% polyester, and two, it needs to be a light colored garment or just completely white. All right, so there are specific sublimation types of garments out there, but that's not recommended for cotton. All right, so if you are using sublimation and it's not showing up, this is where we most commonly see that. However, it is something that is common with transfer paper as well, because not all transfer paper is completely opaque. And then also some heat transfer vinyls are made with a translucent finish. And that's exactly what we did here. So you always want to consider the type of substrate you're applying to, and then also what type of transfer you're going to use. So we solved this by just choosing a opaque heat transfer vinyl that we know is going to show up on a nice dark colored garment. Right, so this is royal. This is also royal as well on here, but you can't tell because of it being completely translucent. So make sure that you're considering your substrate and the type of transfer that you're going to be using so that your design is actually showing up as you're applying your artwork or your design. Okay. So that was four mistakes we went through already. I'll go ahead and repeat those real quick. I see Michelle commenting soft scrub cleaner. I can provide a link to that afterwards. It's found at your local Walmart or any type of convenience store, but I can't remember the brand, so I will provide a link to you after this. All right, so let's go through those first four mistakes. We have crooked design, the design is backwards, we didn't apply adhesive side down, and also my transfer isn't showing up on the garment. All right, our last two. The first one is melting or scorching. And this is one of the most common one we get questions about because there are some heat sensitive fabrics out there. So we do have a comparison of 100% polyester t-shirts. You can see the right t-shirt really has a large heat print box. And that is what we call scorching. All right, so that is from using too much heat on a heat-sensitive fabric, and there are ways to avoid this, and that is by choosing one and the right type of technology for the garment. All right, so 100% polyester is one of the most common ones, in addition to tri-blends that scorch under high heat. So we want to find the solution for that, and there are a couple. The first technology to use would be a low temp application. And that's the first one we always recommend, is using something that's around 280 to 300 degrees. Now, that mistake was created all because we just didn't follow the application instructions. So the transfer we did apply onto that 100% polyester t-shirt was Elastiprints from Transfer Express, which is known for using on athletic wear or performance wear, where it's going to be moisture wicking or heat sensitive. So Elastiprints applies as low as 300 degrees for just 12 seconds at a medium pressure. So those are the three key things we want to focus on when working with heat sensitive fabrics, is what our time is, our temperature, and our pressure. Because we want it to be at a low temp, we don't want the dwell time to be too long, and of course we don't want our pressure putting too much on to that fabrication. All right, so the second one, because it was scorched, it was all because the temperature was just too high and we weren't following those application instructions to a T. All right, so just make sure whenever you are working with 100% polyester, you're choosing the right solution. Low temp, low dwell time, and also a light to medium pressure so that you're not putting too much of that heat too firmly on the substrate. Okay. Another solution is what we call a heated lower platen, or our power platen family. So we do offer platens that apply the transfer from underneath the garment, all right, because there are some substrates out there that even though it is at a low temp for the application instruction, it's still scorching or it's still getting the heat print mark. So our power platens, we'll definitely provide a link in the comments after this so you can check them out. But they are, they have a pillow incorporated inside of them. They heat up to a 320 degrees so that we're applying the transfer from underneath the garment as opposed to smashing the heat all on top. So essentially, we are scorching the garment, but it's just inside and you can't see it. So at that point, it doesn't matter. We still save the garment. It's still sellable at that point. Right, so we do have other educational videos on that particular technology. So if you are interested in checking that out, you can visit our YouTube or follow the link that we'll provide here shortly. All right, so that is solution for melting or scorching. And then finally, we have the transfer isn't applying or it's coming off in the wash. And this can be a number of things. And the first thing it's gonna come down to is the application instructions. So for instance, we have a garment here that was messed up. And you can see here that the top of the four peeled off as well as the top of the two. And some of it is still lifting in some areas. Now, why could this have happened? Some of us will directly just jump to the conclusion that it's the transfer, it's not working, but there are some other considerations to think about before we consider it's just a defaulting to a faulty transfer. So, one of those things is the application instructions. So for instance, I followed everything, time, temperature, and pressure, but what I didn't consider was whether this was a hot peel or a cold peel. So this particular product is a cold peel, and I tried peeling it hot right away after I heat applied it. So it started tearing after I let it sit. I pulled the rest away and then it all applied because I let it cool. So here is that same transfer applied a second time by using the peel cool method, and it all applied very durably. All right, so as long as we're following those application instructions, time, temperature, pressure, what type of substrate I'm applying to, and also it can go as far as care instructions. All right, so maybe you did follow time, temperature, and pressure to a T, and you did peel cold or peel warm or whatever those suggestions were, and your customer comes back and it's saying, hey, this is coming off of the garment. At that point, it comes down to your care instructions. So not all heat transfers are made the same in the industry. Some are tested and washed in industrial wash cycles that's great for workwear, and others aren't even recommended to be dried on high heat. They must be line dried. So you always want to consider the type of transfer you're using for what type of job. But before you give that job to the customer, you want to make sure you're giving them the care instructions as well, because if they're not following it and you still recommended it to them at that time, it's still going to be good for you because you gave them the care instructions and you followed all of everything to a T. So it's going to still work out well for you as long as you're providing them with those care instructions. All right, so another thing to take into consideration is that substrate. All right, so some transfers are made specifically for nylon fabrications and some are made specifically just for cotton and cotton poly. Now, those will always be provided for you from Stahls. We'll always tell you what substrate it should be applied to, what the care instructions are, and also what time, temperature, and pressure you should be applying at. So it takes the guesswork out for you so you know you're getting a quality transfer every time and it's going to be durable. All right, so those are the top heat printing mistakes and how you can solve them or any challenges that you might be going through. If you guys have any questions, feel free to comment those in. But there are a lot of other mistakes out there, and if you haven't made any of these, I'm sure eventually you will, but just know you're not alone. These are all common things that happen all the time, and we try to find out what processes we can provide to you to avoid these things and keep them from happening. Before we go ahead and close the live broadcast, a quick announcement. We are doing a live class next Thursday. Zach Ellsworth will be presenting on top 10 reasons to own a vinyl cutter. That goes from what type of heat transfer vinyl that you can be utilizing to get more profit from customers and a lot of other technical things that come along with a vinyl cutter. So be sure to check that out if you are in the market for a new machine such as a vinyl cutter. And again, that is next Thursday at 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thank you so much for joining me. We'll see you next week.